We have one more poet. Now, I do want to remind you, in the back over here, the poets have their published works for sale after the concert is over. And all the musical acts, or many of the musical acts, have CDs for sale behind the bookshelf behind you. Including us. We have a live concert that we did last year at the Thoreau Center in Lincoln, Massachusetts, and that was recorded during last year's walk, and that's available up here too. As well as, I'm not sure, how many of you have seen the Mass Walking Tour posters around the West Bridgewater area, the black and white posters?
Nope.
Yeah, those are hand-drawn by an artist in Somerville, Dan Blakes. And he's done them for us each year since 2010. And we have them so you can see them framed in the back afterwards. And our good friend Bill Condry has been driving them around the state and visiting us, and so we don't have to carry them. So we have one more poet that's going to come up here and speak for you. His name is Winston Bolton.
Not exactly as crippled as I look. I have a balance problem. And how does anybody follow that act? Well, I have followed it. I write lyric poetry. Some of you know me. And you know my friend, my mentor and editor. I have one book out so far. I'm probably the oldest poet to ever have a first book. But the air might die. I have my pages pinned here. All right, I'll read on the father's side first. I'm sure you're all familiar with the poet Wallace Stevens, aren't we?
Oh yeah.
Wallace Stevens is a major poet, major American poet. There are major, minor, and forgettable poets. There's an epigraph to the poem. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Somebody raise their hand. There may be always a time of innocence. There is never a place. This is from his poem, long philosophical poem, called The Auroras of Autumn. There is a place of innocence, as when the field you had to cross lay white before you in the gathered night. The moon, big as a cabbage in the trees, caught perhaps in the trees. And you on an errand somewhere that made you both emissary and the one waiting on the other side. I said the father's side. That field was not guilty of your footfalls. It had never wanted you especially, but there you entered, felt the frost-like dew wet your legs, and heard the little life come to a standstill as you moved. An edge advancing in its own alarm, as a ripple in the pond goes on and on, affecting a beyond one cannot see. A change had taken place. The field no longer was alone, no longer innocent, but like a skin clothed your intent, became a worn garment as you strode before it, trailing something torn. What does that mean? Well, I thought it means that. It's a short poem. Getting a little lost. Face off, this might appeal to the walkers. I hope they don't get a little lost. I drive the back roads among acres of farmland to get a little lost. Hints of roofs, houses on the horizon, keeping their distance. the stillness of woods, but what of quiet beneath a broken sky? A way of being alone, letting the eye run out like a dog given its freedom. This poem, personally, not I don't care that much for it anymore. And it got me into poetry, as did a number of other poems. Poetry is, you know, the mecca of American verse. If you can get into poetry, no matter what you've done in the world, you could be a major criminal. But if you've gotten into poetry, you have made it. In 1965, to John Coltrane on my record player, an LP, vinyl, on vinyl then. And after I heard John Coltrane, I don't know what he was doing. It might have been Love Supreme, it could have been anything. I sat down, and it didn't take me long to write this poem. Might we too, after listening to John Coltrane, we who have lived for song, yet never ourselves sung, never mastered the strain, the horn, made a living apart from the voice within us, we who have sat in hopeless admiration as lookers on, stood at the high office window, watching the hobo cross his tracks, slinging himself into a passing boxcar with the agility of the acrobat, or disappear among the underslung shadows, riding the rails into dangerous night. Is it talent or persistence? Might we too have done that? Roll the miles off, over tars, ties. Roll the bars off, over ties, bars, and rifts of God's sweat.
Nice.
Thanks, God.
Nice.
Thank you. Thank you. That it is talent, not persistence. Although I have written some music that I'm very proud of, music, piano music. I have not scored most of it, it's on tape, because it's so hard to score. One more here, and then I have a poem for my new book. This is called Leaving Something Out. Another epigraph. Well, it's not an epigraph, it's a script. The Postman Roulant. If you're familiar, it's in the Museum of Fine Arts of Boston. Vincent van Gogh's Portrait of the Postman Roulant. To get it all in, you have to leave something out. Van Gogh's Portrait of Old Roulant, for instance. How part of the chair is missing. You have to leave something out so the eye will attend to the arm curving there in its blue reality. Well, one more here. This is from my new book, coming out in a month or so, called Among Ruins. Harvest. To run barefoot again in the cold, damp grass when summer's past and the harvest in. The harvest in, tinned and on the shelves, and the great pumpkins rolled in the piles. I have stood alone upon the meadow in first light and watched night gather up her stars and wondered, when did time take me by the hand and say, old man, this is where you are. I don't want to leave it that way. I wrote this yesterday. Beth's going to brain me because she's not allowed me to read my appointment. This is brief. Title. I can't find the title part, which is probably a bad sign. My house is wide open these hot nights. Someone could come in with a small light and kiss me. I'll take off my hat. I am open as an infant to contingency. Were I small, I could be carried from my bed. Up every 2 hours to pee, saying the Lord's Prayer in search of sleep, reciting poetry, awaiting REM and the little theater of the mind. Still, there are times when you might find me at your disposal. Really, I never hear you come or go. It's a loaded Glock 9mm with a safety lock. That's bullshit. No arms for me. Thank you all.
We have one more musical act before we perform for you, the Massachusetts Walking Tour. Are you guys enjoying yourself? I really do appreciate Gus Smith here. He's put a lot of effort into this particular program for you folks, as has Glenn Savoy of the Friends of the Library. And ourselves, making sure the promotion gets out there. So this last act that we have is a duo of friends of ours who performed at last year's Mass Walking Tour, Andy and Judy.
Well, good evening, everybody. We are Andy and Judy, and congratulate all the previous the acts that came up before us. It's outstanding. A lot of shoes to fill. We're going to do three originals for you, and they're all on the CDs that are on that back table. First one's a rail song, it's called On That Rail.
Dogs and the bosses are closing from behind. They chase me from car to car in every stop and town. But I'm always a step ahead when I hit that ground. I got no roots now.
No roots now.
I got
no laid on time.
Said hold me back so.
Don't hold me.
I have no change of mind. I'm moving
on. I'm blazing my own.
Find myself in home camps up and down the line. The beans and the fires are burning all the time.
They keep me warm for just one night, the stories and the songs.
Before the sun, I've packed my bags, then I
move along.
I got no roots now.
No roots now. I got no laid down time.
They hold me back so.
Don't hold me.
I have no chains of mine. The factory's all gone quiet, the city's turned to dust.
Fellow travelers, my salvation, my family and my friend.
Walk across this country till glory is our end. Well, I got no roots now.
Find me on the
This next one is a song that Judy wrote. And the first one was mine. And we, running joke is, do we collaborate? No. We're married, but we don't. But that's okay. It works out well. This one is a waltz. It's our latest, and actually it's not on one of those CDs, I fibbed. And it's a waltz. If you'd like to get up to it, please do it.
It is called Dancing in Dreams.
There you go. I'm ready.
Thank you.
This one does have a little bit of audience participation.
Actually, the walking tour helped inspire this. After last year, we played with them, and we were talking a bit about their trekking through the woods and everything. The thought came to my mind, follow your dreams, it takes you through the brambles and the briars. And I just had that brambles and the briars in the head, and this song came of it. So you guys kind of inspired this song called Follow Your Dreams. Okay, ready?
All right.
I still have
just
keep me clear. A waltz. Ready? This is not a waltz. They say the world is traveled is a hard way, but their feet have trod before.
performance, and I invite them to come out on stage now.
the good roll up the sleeves, Jordan and my heart are travel at me.
Thank you. town when I got there yesterday. Down in town, down to Alton, on the hot summer day.
I want to remind everybody that the poets who spoke before have books for sale over here, all their published works. Jim has all this photography over there, and I believe when we first arrived at the library today, he sold. Is that true?
Yes.
One of his
I
works.
I think we saw him sell a piece today. That was very exciting.
Inspirational, but that's all the way in the back over there. There's another big open space with all of his work, so make sure none of you leave without checking out.
Where's your stuff?
Where's our stuff? Well, our stuff and all the musical stuff is over there. As far as our CDs, the musical artists who played before have CDs over there, and the posters from this year's walking tour and all the years' walking tours before, so you can check out Dan Blakesley's work.
And there's still a lot of cake, so you all have cakes in our backpack.
No, that's happened before. Somebody made this brilliant sponge cake with raspberries, and she made us take it all.
When I got here today, I walked out in the other room, and there were four kids out there with the biggest backpacks I have ever seen. And I thought they'd just try to get through your intersection down here. Now that I find out what they were doing.
Yeah, we've had servicemen tell us they've come to our concerts and said, you guys are just stupid. Doing what you're doing with zero training and you're not avid hikers. We're gonna do another acapella song.
Yeah, it was great to hear the John Henry poem before from Faye. Kind of hit close to what this song touches on, the man versus machine theme. It's an old one called You Damn Old Piney Mountains, and another true story.
Well, sit down, buddy, we'll drink and smoke. Woman, don't you weep for me. My hands can't fill and my heart's been broke. You damn old Piney Mountain. I lost my fingers in a Galax mill. Buddy, sing a sad old song. My heart got broke in them you pine hills. Lord, and my time ain't long. Well, I started into logging when I was in my prime. Woman, don't you weep for me. Hitching up spruce on the big drag line. You damn old Piney Mountain. Where the skidders get to bucking when the gears come down. Buddy, sing a sad old song. Making God's own thunder on the new cut ground. Lord, and my time ain't long. We was fighting over nothing and drinking too hard. Woman, don't you weep for me. Riding up to camp on a flat wheel car. You damn old Piney Mountain. I was 30 years hanging on the old chain brake. Buddy, sing a sad old song. I was laid off and paid off in 58. Lord, and my time ain't long. Then they sold off the skidders to the scrap iron yard. Woman, don't you weep for me. And I moved down to Virginia when the times got hard. You damn old Piney Mountain. I lost my fingers in a steel band saw. Buddy, sing a sad old song. Now my fiddle just hangs untuned on the wall. Lord, and my time ain't long. Now the trees have grown up in the logging road. Woman, don't you weep for me. The wildflowers bloom where the big shades blow. You damn old Piney Mountain. There's nothing left for me but to drink and smoke. Buddy, sing a sad old song. My hands can't fiddle and my heart's been broke. Lord, in my time ain't long.
Part of the reason why we started walking in 2010 was just to get our music across the state. Ryan and I, in the hardest way we could think imaginable. We've really been touring the country in a van or a sedan, and we thought we needed more exercise and love hiking and work getting out. But part of the reason is to bring arts and culture to all the towns in Massachusetts, of which we've visited about 70 by the end of this trip. And I hear, does anybody here know how many towns there are in Massachusetts?
351.
I've heard 352. Can I hear 352? Everybody says it's different. 351.
Yeah.
And somebody actually piped up and said we should visit the disincorporated towns of Quabbin as well. I thought that would take scuba gear and also make
just
it
to the graveyard.
Try out. Yeah.
They moved all the gravel.
That's true. And they still hold town meetings. it's not easy, but it's definitely rewarding, not only to get to perform for all of you folks, but to bring together a lot of different artists from the community to perform for you.
How many people saw one of the local performers that they had never seen before tonight? Awesome. So that's exactly what we're out here to do. Your community seems to actually have a pretty good support for arts with some of the towns that we visited, for example, Huntington, Massachusetts, which was our second concert on the first walking tour, had not had a concert in over 20 years.
Wow.
We don't want that to happen again, which is why we're here.
So we're going to play another song called Hard Times and Woes. Hard times, there'll be woes along both sides of the road. There'll be times when giving up seems like the ending always comes. Be it heaven, be it gold, to quench the thirst inside. May faith stay in the saddle as we ride off in the morning. There's a way, there's a means, you must take the reins and ride. Amen.
get you first inside your soul. May faith stay inside as you ride off in the morning.
Swapperino there. Switcheroo.
They practice that.
Hey,
male bonding. You guys can switch it up just as fun. Even if you can't play the saxophone, pick up the saxophone.
Yeah. Good idea.
Yeah. The saxophone.
That's what we did.
Yeah.
That's what I'm on another round.
That's what you get off on, the switching of the instruments. That's your super easy.
Yeah. We have concerts, but people don't usually switch instruments.
Okay.
Yeah, we're going to do an acrobatic demonstration.
Good.
This one is a happy little number about rambling around the world, searching for your one true love, called I Will Find My Lover By and By. It's on our CD. It goes a little something like this. By and by,
oh, by and by,
I will find my lover by and by.
Ooh,
and I know that when I meet her, I will love her till I die. I will
find my lover by and by.
Do a crackwish. It's not that kind of show.
Do you do like a toss?
Whoa. We're sore.
So, it's pretty nice playing in the library. In fact, before the show started, I actually was perusing the adult nonfiction and trying to find a book on poison ivy and poison oak because I was a little bit, just a little bit on my legs. Bay Circuit Trail is great. It's actually pretty well marked. Most of the trails are pretty clear, but I mean, just as you guys know, there's a lot of poison ivy even by the guardrails on the highway. So I was trying to look up some information on it, like how to identify it, and what I found out is the whole leaves of three, let it be three. It's not true, because poison ivy can actually have sometimes up to 17 leaves on like one stalk. So it's amorphous and it's deceptive, and so it's constantly changing. So I was like, okay, great. that, and apparently there's not really much you can do about it besides avoiding it. But if you guys have any, you know, wives' tales or remedies to help with the itching.
I see a lot of nods.
Yeah, talk to me. Like, you know, I'm down to like sitting on my head upside down with shaking something, like whatever you guys have. Anyways, the point is, I'm going to sing a song now. It has nothing to do with poison ivy. It's actually an old country song by Claude King. It's called I Won't Be Long in Your Town. It's very fitting since tomorrow we'll be hiking, 8 miles? 7 miles?
All
7
miles.
Not even.
All the way to East Bridgewater. You see East Bridgewater from Ann's house. This sign says, you know, right. We should have just got dropped off there and that would be it.
Cheating.
Yeah, don't take rides. Yeah. Except for Glenn.
We got to make our walk. And then anything else throughout the day, we'll go wherever anyone wants us to go in a car. We walk our distance, and then we're done walking.
And you did walk to the library from my house.
Yeah, we did.
That's right.
Since I was late.
You didn't show up. You're just gonna bring it. See, I'll be there by 5.
It's a short walk.
Watching that awesome cake. Did I mention if you guys don't eat the cake, we have to carry it in our backpack?
That won't go well in a Ziploc bag. Not like the Angel Food cake.
I guess that I was
little bit from sinus infection, but I have a feeling there might be some fans of Buffy St. Marie in the audience, perhaps.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm gonna try to sing Many a Mile for you. I apologize if I don't make it through, but I'm going to try my best. And I hope you like the song. It was actually written by Patrick Sky. Buffy is the one who made it popular. Unfortunately, a lot of her music wasn't heard by as many people as it should have been because she sang out against the war, and some people didn't like that, so her music didn't really get a lot of airplay on the radio. But her records are great, and she's still singing today. She just released an album this year. So I hope you guys enjoy the song. It's called Many of Mine.
Yeah. bells, yeah. Okay. Freshen in.
We have one more song. Thank you guys so much for being here. Come up and say hi afterwards. Go check out Jim's photography and works way in the back there. Check out Poet's books here. Check out the musical CDs and the posters for the previous Massachusetts walking tours. And eat some cake. And don't be timid about eating that center portion that says Massachusetts Walking Tour. We'll all take a bit home with us tonight from this great concert.
Yeah, please, go ahead. Like, eat my face if you want.
Well, actually, it's the logo of the squirrel.
I was saying next year, though, they should definitely make a cake with our faces on.
Yeah. So this next one, Bob Dylan used to bum around with, and you might know it if you do. I really hope that you will sing along with us because we are very tired.
Yeah, let's make some noise.
Walk around the premises,
don't stay in your seats, we'll play one more song, we'll play, we'll close out tomorrow.